All right, welcome to the apply part of the workshop. The goal here is to actually apply and use what we're learning in the workshop into an actual development of an e-learning lesson. And so what we're going to do is actually use PowerPoint as our primary authoring tool, and this is actually selected for a couple of reasons. One, a lot of people have access to PowerPoint, and two, PowerPoint is actually a very powerful e-learning development tool when it's used properly. And so what we're going to do is we're going to find out how some of these development principles apply to the actual creation of an e-learning lesson using PowerPoint. And so the first thing that we want to do is actually resize the size of the PowerPoint window. So what I've done here is just opened up a blank PowerPoint file, and this is what I get. I get kind of a 4x3 sized screen. It's kind of a canvas to work with, and PowerPoint has put in the click to add title and subtitles and things of that nature. So what I actually want to do first is modify some elements of this file so that it makes it a little bit easier to work with for e-learning development. So first, as I mentioned, I want to resize the dimensions of the PowerPoint file. To do that, I'm going to go in here to Design, the Design tab, and select Page Setup. And I've predetermined some dimensions that I'd like to use. And the width, type in 12.5. And for the height, type 8.333. And you can follow along as I do this, or if you'd like to go back and watch this first, then go back and work through the activities, that's completely fine too. This is merely a guide as you go through the process. Okay, so once we've resized the project, you'll notice that it's a little bit longer than it is tall, and so that's kind of what we want. It's a this will end up being 900 pixels wide by 600 pixels tall. So as we begin talking in pixels now, so one of the first things that will be extremely beneficial to you as you begin working in PowerPoint as an e-learning development tool is to use the master slides features in PowerPoint. And some of you may have used this when giving PowerPoint presentations, but you'll find that this is extremely helpful for developing e-learning in PowerPoint. So to do that, we actually want to select the View tab, and then we're going to select Slide Master. And when I do this, this pulls up a whole list of different slide types that have been pre-populated by PowerPoint. You can kind of see them there. We'll find that many of those slides are just going to get in the way of actually what we're going to be doing in development. So kind of our first step here is going to be a little bit of cleanup, and we're going to be doing a lot of deleting. And so the first thing I'd like to do is take out this I'm going to actually leave one main slide and one sub-slide. So to do that, I'm going to begin selecting these to delete. And it's actually going to require that we leave this master slide title, so we'll actually have one main slide and two sub-slides there, because PowerPoint won't allow us to delete it. So I'm going to select the third one down. I'm going to scroll all the way down to the bottom while holding the Shift key, select the final one, and then I'm just going to click Delete. Select Delete on the keyboard. So now I've left with three slides, one main, two sub slides. So this main slide that's listed as number one is actually where PowerPoint is going to pull the main primary styles from. So think of this as something that's going to remain consistent throughout the e-learning lesson. And one of the things that we'll find as we go through, consistency is a huge asset in making sure learners feel comfortable and that they can apply the information that they need to and work with the e-learning lesson. Just makes it far more learnable. But what we're actually going to do is we're going to do some visual design in this later. So I'm going to actually highlight, I'm just clicking and dragging across the screen, and I'm going to click Delete. So now I have a blank page to begin with. This first one I'm actually going to leave alone. It is a file that we won't use, but it's something that PowerPoint puts in and actually keeps in automatically to identify the master, the first slide. So we'll leave that there, but I'm going to focus here on this second one. And so what I'd like to do is, again, do a little cleanup on this particular master slide. This will be representative of where we'll begin placing content, and we'll talk about that in the next tutorial series. But first, we're going to clean up by just highlighting this bottom footer row, highlighting that and selecting Delete. We're going to build in some custom features for that. And then we're going to go in and select this text box. go into the Home tab and undo the bullet list in there. One of the things that we're not going to have a lot of in our e-learning lesson is bullets. There is a reason why it's called bullet points, and we're actually going to stay away from bullet points in this lesson. Okay, so right now what we have is a very cleaned up PowerPoint file that we're going to then use for our templates. And we're going to talk about templates in just a moment, but I do want to point out several things. One is I have not done any visual enhancements to this file. It's very black and white, very plain. We're going to deal with that later. The thing that we're looking at right now during this section is to make sure that we set up the foundation for our e-learning lesson that it's going to be successful. So using some of those principles, those multimedia learning principles that we talked about in the content, in the equip section of this workshop, we're going to see how those can then be applied through translating that into the templates in this lesson. So for now, we're done with this file. I'm going to go up here and select save. And in the next tutorial series, we're going to talk about how to set up these screen templates.